Hello, I'm Jesse with American Radon Mitigation. One thing we've noticed with radon mitigation courses is they don't really give you a lot of hands-on options. And after talking to several other contractors, and me being one of them back in the day, when I was first learning, is I didn't know anything. And we had to struggle and kind of fumble our way through for many years, and we still don't know everything. But one thing that we want to try to do to solve that is offer some hands-on training. So we've got a couple opportunities. One where you can come out to a house that we're working on and learn anything from pressure field extension to how to size the pipe, how to select the radon fan, where to put that suction point, optimal mitigation where we're not only going for the greatest reduction but also the greatest energy efficiency. So that's one option. Our second option is where we actually come to a job that you're working on and help you with whatever you want help with. So maybe it's a difficult to mitigate house, you just want to understand pressure field extension better and help reduce callbacks and offer better value to your customers. So I'm here with Dustie. He is one of my friends, he owns Mr. Radon. And Dustie, why don't you tell us about this house?
I was obviously contracted through a seller's agent to mitigate this home down from a 9 picocurie initial reading and mitigated it through drain tile depressurization and went right into the sump lid, replaced with a 24-inch polycarbonate and put in my break with the Femco. Everything looked good. Thought I had great communication throughout the house. How I would know that, I don't know, because I didn't actually do PFE prior. I took the assumption the drain tile was going to work on a twin home. Came back 72 hours later to get my test and we had a 2.6. And down from 9, that's a pretty good number. The secondary factor was she had us test the daughter's room on the opposite side of the house, and it came back in with a 3.7 and a peak of like a 7.2. She was not happy with that, nor was I. I came back to figure out why I wasn't getting the communication and the reduction that I was expecting with drain tile to find out it was a single tube drain tile that ran into the garage, or at least what we assume might be a daylight drain tile, and that's where I'm at now. So I called Jesse for a training opportunity. That where did I miss? And what we have established so far is I do not have communication at the full perimeter foundation. Once we go downstairs, we can kind of show you where we've started and what our next steps will be.
Sounds good. Should we get started?
Absolutely.
All right. So the first thing I wanted Dusty to do yesterday when he called is drill some diagnostic test holes so that we could see what his baseline was, if his radon system was reaching or creating suction under the house, because we found the key to getting your levels low is to engineer a system that creates suction under the entire house. So I wanted him to do a few different spots, one near the center of the house and one opposite of his suction point. So this is opposite his suction point. This is on the walkout corner of the house. This is probably gonna be our hardest test hole to reach. So we're not reaching anything there, even with the radon fan off. With it on, we have no communication to this point. He is reaching one spot, and we can go take a look at, see where you're reaching. So yesterday, Dusty and I established that this is the only test hole that we're reaching. He's got the radon system on now, and we established that it has exterior drain tile, meaning the drain tile is on the outside of the house, so it doesn't really do us a whole lot of good here. And we're just wiggling this test hole here, because that drain tile is about 2 feet away from us on the other side of the foundation. So our next step last night was to seal under the shower because we had a big opening there. So let's take a look at that. So before we could do any accurate diagnostic work here, we had to seal the plumbing block out underneath the shower. So it's like a 1 foot by 1 foot hole that's open to the soil. So we just used this great stuff window and door so that it didn't expand too much. We were able to get the edges, and then to get underneath, we used my longer 36-inch foam gun to seal that opening off, and then that allows us to do accurate pressure field extension testing in this area.
All right, so after Jesse and I finished sealing the shower, we moved to the sewer cleanout and basically routed this tube, this pipe underground with the sewer scope and locator. And as I fed it, Jesse was tracing it with the locator and marking very specific points on the ground so that we could have a route. While you were routing it, We found that the depth was very consistent at about 1 foot, 2 inches deep, which is great. And it ran basically diagonal and then turned hard east toward the front of the house to exit. At that point, Jesse had the idea of drilling a test hole at the 45 degree turn and found out that we were gaining a massive amount of communication at 212 pascals just by hitting that underground trenching and that settling that the trenching offers, right?
Yeah, so we had good communication at that test hole that you had 2.7 at before. But keep in mind, you know, we're only 6 feet away from it where we're applying suction, but it also allowed us to reach everything else. Didn't give us great communication, but once we get a pit installed here, then we should get better communication. So the reason we want that plumbing trench is because we get settling that occurs for next to plumbing. So any house that doesn't have interior drain tile or, you know, really porous rock or something under the slab, I'm always going to go after plumbing because I want to tap into that settling that has occurred, because essentially takes your suction point that might be 20, 30, 40 gallons. And if it's settled, you know, an inch or two, your suction point is now hundreds of gallons and you're sucking on that whole plumbing network, which gives you the best shot of reaching everything.
Absolutely. Yeah. Well, that's where I, after yesterday's work, explaining to me that with that pipe running here and with the foundation off the corner of this wall, putting a diagnostic here and checking that one more time, I'm going to make every assumption that this is a good spot for a core hole. And that will be my final plan, as we'll put a core, drill out here, run the pipe up and back to the main trunk with some dampers just to make sure we control airflow,
yep,
retest, and I think we will get the wind that we're looking for.
Yep. And the reason that we're going around the corner there is because we've got the water main that likely runs through here. This would be another great spot right here, but that's probably right where they ran that water main, and that's a less risky move to go around the corner there.
We don't want to drill through any copper water lines.
Better to be safe than sorry. Dusty, was this valuable?
Absolutely. It was an experience that for myself and my company, I can take forward. I look forward to other opportunities to bring you in on other projects. I also look forward to visiting you on site. You know, you offer that as a service too. And I think seeing somebody in their work environment versus you in my work environment can be a valuable tool also. It gives you an opportunity to see things through a different lens. So with that said, my expertise level has gone up slightly. I do have over 100 mitigations under my belt. I'm one of the newest, if not the newest mitigator in Minnesota. And I'm always looking to learn, because as well as they do with the training through the state and some of the other training venues, you only get a week. You get mitigation and testing all rolled into one, very little hands-on. I think this is an opportunity for any mitigator in the state or in the country who's trying to learn. It cannot hurt to see it. First of all, if you've never seen it, it gives you an opportunity to see it hands-on with somebody who does this daily, which I do not. I don't take that many jobs. It also is valuable for the people that have been doing this to possibly see it from another lens. So with that said, I can't thank you enough for visiting me on site. I do look forward to finding a site where you're at and coming to work on another project and another subject matter in the project, because PFE and selection of a section suction point has given me an opportunity to be a better mitigator as a whole from here into the future. And I thank you very much.
Yep, you're welcome.
I appreciate that.
Thanks for having me.
Absolutely.
So one follow-up question for you is, what would you say to somebody out there that is thinking about maybe taking this hands-on training?
You don't hesitate. The simplistic part of it is that if you aren't the smartest person in the room, it doesn't matter. If you are, good for you. But there's always an opportunity to learn. There's new technologies, there's new methods that somebody else can bring into play. And if you can offer the public, your clientele, and your employees and your company information and learning that makes you better, makes you more efficient, and makes you more profitable why would you not invest the time and money into an opportunity and a training session like this? That's what I have to say, and I will do it again. No questions asked, no heartbeat taken.
All right. Well, thanks, Dustie. It was a pleasure. Again, pleasure coming out.
Appreciate it.
Thank you.
Thank you.
If you're interested in learning more about our online training opportunities, click the link in the description. I'm Jesse with American Radon Mitigation. Thanks for watching. What's my question? What should I say? Cut.